The Redmi K20 and K20 Pro are identical looking smartphones. A lot of people have been asking me what are the differences, and even those who know the differences have been asking me which one to buy, whether it's worth spending the extra money to get the K20 Pro or not. Let's clear it up today. My name is Ashwin Sundar, this is Technology Jock. Please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon for regular video updates. This video is brought to you by Squarespace. Squarespace is an online service that helps you create amazing websites all by yourself without any prior knowledge. Stick with me till the end of the video for more information. Let's now get started with the comparison. Let's begin with the cosmetic changes. Okay, I'm just kidding. There are no cosmetic changes. Both phones look identical to each other. Of course, the colors are different here, but actually both phones are available in all three colors. So let's just focus on the differences. The biggest one is the chip inside. The K20 Pro uses the flagship Snapdragon 855 chip, while the K20 uses the mid-range Snapdragon 730 chip. I had actually told you guys in the unboxing video of the K20 that in some benchmark tests, the 730 actually performed as good as, if not better than, the 835 and 845 to an extent. In some cases. Remember, they were the flagship chips in 2017 and 18. So, to find out the differences you will see in real life usage, I'm gonna open 10 apps on both phones side by side, render a video, and play PUBG at high graphic settings for a few minutes. I believe these will give you the most realistic result. Let's go. So except YouTube, every app opened faster on the K20 Pro. But mind you, the time difference was in milliseconds, so basically negligible. Opening PUBG was noticeably faster though. The difference was 6 seconds. For the render test, we are gonna use Adobe Premiere Clip. I have the exact same video clip on both phones. Let's slow it down to 50% speed and render it in 1080p resolution. I am fast forwarding it, by the way. This is one of the most CPU intensive tasks, and obviously the Snapdragon 855 chip is ahead of the 730. Well, had it been 710 or any other similar chip, the difference would have been even bigger. The reason 730 is able to come reasonably close is because it uses two Cryo 470 cores. They are the latest ones from Qualcomm, no other mid-range chip uses them. The 855 finished the render in 90 seconds, while the K20 finished it in 110 seconds. So the K20 Pro is approximately 20% faster here. The K20 Pro can handle PUBG in HDR graphics at extreme frame rate. So I played for almost half an hour continuously, and even towards the end, the performance was really good. There was still no considerable drop in frame rate or anything. Now, when you open PUBG for the first time on both phones, the default graphics setting is high on both. In that setting, the K20 Pro performs really well, but when you go to settings, you can see that these are the maximum supported graphics settings on the K20, while on the K20 Pro, you can set the graphics to HDR and frame rate to extreme. So this is where the 855 chip shows how much more capable it is. Next up, charging times. Both phones have the same battery capacity, 4000mAh, but the K20 Pro supports 27 watts charging, which is Quick Charge 4 Plus, while the K20 supports only up to 18 watts charging, which is Quick Charge 3.0. But the thing is, both phones come with the same 18 watts charger in the box anyway. If you want to charge your K20 Pro faster, you need to purchase the QC 4 Plus adapter separately. Link in the description, check it out. The difference in charging times between QC 3.0 and QC 4 Plus don't seem to be mind-blowing or anything. QC 3.0 takes an extra 10 minutes to charge the phone to 100%. Here's a detailed charging test, check it out if you're interested. Now, another huge difference seems to be related to the cameras. Seems to be. Yes, the K20 Pro uses IMX586 sensor, while the K20 uses IMX582 sensor, But as far as I know, as far as the results of my test go, the 582 is just a rebranded 586, but with inferior video recording capabilities. The IMX 582 supports only up to 4K at 30 frames per second, while the IMX 586 supports up to 4K 60fps. The Snapdragon 730 chip also supports only up to 4K 30fps, so that's probably why Xiaomi decided to go with the 582 sensor to cut the cost. And naturally, the K20 slow motion video capabilities are also not as good as the K20 Pro's. The K20 Pro can do 1080p recording at all frame rates, while the K20 slow-mo options are limited to 720p. One more thing, the K20 Pro has a motion tracking feature. It uses the ultra-wide camera to keep track of the subject, but the K20 doesn't have it. Apart from these, everything else is pretty much similar on both phones. Just look at the specifications of both sensors. 48 megapixels, half-inch sensor size, 0.8 microns pixel size, f1.75 aperture. Alright, let's have a look at some photos. As you can see, both are identical. There is absolutely no difference. And let's not even talk about the ultra-wide-angle camera and the telephoto camera, because literally the same sensors and lenses are used on both phones. Selfies? Once again, similar results. Same goes to low-light photos. Equally bright, same noise levels, similar color reproduction. The only thing that's slightly different is the night mode performance. The K20 Pro's image has more detail, like here the speedometer values are reasonably clear. Now, since night mode is a software feature, I feel maybe Xiaomi intentionally made the K20 a little inferior. So overall, barring night mode and high frame rate video recording, there is no reason you should make a decision based on camera performance. Okay, last one. The K20 Pro uses dual frequency GPS. It just goes through a wider range of frequency bands to get better accuracy. In most scenarios, this won't be any different from the regular GPS on other phones, including the K20. But in some busy urban areas where there is a lot of interference, you will notice that dual GPS is slightly more accurate. So those are all the differences between these phones. Now, which one should you get? The price difference is approximately 5,000 rupees. The answer depends a lot on how heavy your usage is. This video is not about listing out the specs of both phones and asking you to pick one. I showed everything in detail so that you know exactly what the differences are, what exactly the K20 Pro can do that the K20 can't. If you ask me, well, the K20 is more than enough for most people out there. For day-to-day usage, like opening apps, social media, etc., both are almost equally good. Cameras are equally good, barring high frame rate video capabilities and night mode performance. The K20 Pro has fast charging support, not the fast charger itself, just fast charging support. But even the QC4 Plus charger doesn't make a huge difference. So the only practical thing you can easily notice in real life usage scenarios is PUBG gameplay. I mean, high end gameplay in general. And other equally intensive tasks like video editing and rendering. Now, don't get me wrong. The K20's gaming performance is great. In fact, it's the best gaming phone around 20,000 rupees now. It's just that the K20 Pro's performance is even better. So forget everything else. If you want the best gaming performance out of your phone, or if you're planning to use the phone for like 3 or 4 years, then get the K20 Pro. If not, the K20 is more than enough. Actually, I would advise you to not stress too much over this. Both phones offer great value for money. So in case you have a really tight budget of 20,000 rupees, please don't spend extra for the K20 Pro. You don't have to go out of your way to arrange the extra amount, and you know, the difference is not that big. You know what is that big and powerful? Squarespace. Like I said, it's a wonderful online tool for building websites. You don't need to design or code anything. There are a lot of beautiful templates to choose from. Just type the keyword and choose a template. From there, you just need to edit the existing content based on your requirements, and done. You can instantly view the mobile version and the tablet version of the website as well. Just in case you get stuck somewhere, Squarespace will help you out. They have an award-winning customer service team available all day, every day. 24/7 literally. So go ahead, try out Squarespace, link can be found in the description. And when you decide to launch your website to the public, you can use the special promo code TechnologyJock to get 10% discount. So that's it. Post your thoughts and questions about the phones below. Would you buy the K20 or the K20 Pro? Let me know that as well. I'd really appreciate it if you hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon. Thanks for watching. For the moment, this is Ashwin Sundar saying goodbye.